Alright, peace, 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 family. Peace. So look, I wanna send a big shout out to all the new members, who, you know, took the time out to join the tribe, man, to show some love. I ain't gonna really do too much talking on this one, man. Trying to get better right, you know, get my energy better right from that, man. So I'm out here getting some of the sun. Got my toes in Mother Nature right now, you feel me? And I'm grounding myself, you know, getting myself back right. And I advise y'all to do the same, but, you know, I'm gonna put another TikTok compilation video together, man, and, you know, put some good videos in there, man. Hopefully, you know, y'all support it and y'all get the full picture of, you know, this true knowledge that's going on and going around, man. You know, like I said, it's a beautiful day. There's vibes outside, man. Go get you some, man. Peace and love, family.
And, you know, all of this information is encoded within us. So, we as the messengers, we as the gods and goddesses who come on here and present this knowledge and talk about this knowledge, you know, all we're trying to do is awaken what's already within you. You feel what I'm saying? Like, all the power that you have is within you. You know what I'm saying? All the knowledge, all everything that you are seeking, you already have it. You just have to be aware of it and put the work in to manifest it into reality. Into your physical life, you feel me? The past, the present, the future is all running simultaneously, you feel me? Like I said, time is an illusion, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, certain TikToks like the Grand Canyon being a portal, being the entrance to Africa, that's facts. Like, there are so many people coming out and starting to put the two and two, starting to put two and two together, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Like, this landmass that we live on, that they've mapped out, is not exactly what the landmass looks like for real. And that they tried to say that there's not enough land or we're overpopulated. That's not true, because, you know, there's a bunch of ancient maps that specifically point out that this landmass is way bigger than what they're saying. You know what I'm saying?
I want you to make me a promise. Are you ready? Make me a promise that you're not going to give up on yourself, that you're not going to continue to talk bad to yourself, that you're not going to talk down upon yourself, because you are amazing. And no one walking this earth has the blueprint, the guidelines to how to be a human. Not one person. So you are doing the best that you know how to do. I know we all need encouragement. Sometimes we all need a little boost. Be mindful, stay grateful, stay blessed. Get surrounded by people who want to see you win, like me. I'm proud of you. Give yourself credit. Do not ever give up on yourself.
Yeah, son, it's over with. I just watched a clip of a Simpsons episode to say it's over with. You know anything about the Simpsons, it's over with. But what's deep about what was said in this episode, a nuclear attack only benefits the opposite side if they're kamikaze or suicidal. An invasion, they can't account for the American people and the free ownership of guns, so they won't invade. But a cyber attack, if they turn the power off on us, for 30 days, do you understand how many people are gonna die? For 6 months, how animalistic and barbaric is gonna get out here? For a year or two, it's gonna look like the end of Terminator. It's gonna really, really reset the tide of time. Prepare for anything, both negative and positive.
Is Egypt in Africa? No, sweetie. Egypt is in China.
Sweetie, Egypt not in China. Check this out. In Alabama, USA.
I gotta get some seeds to clean these bitches out my ore. I had to cut her off, I'm not compatible with tours. I had to meditate, she knocked my chakras out of line. Now I can't find no angel numbers, 1111369. I gotta get some seeds to clean these bitches out my ore. I had to cut her off, I'm not compatible with tours. I had to meditate, she knocked my chakras out of line. Now I can't find no angel numbers, 1111369.
Rashad Jamal speaking truth. Kids finna be
slaves. I know we level a burn this bitch to the ground, nigga. So our kids ain't gotta go through this shit. But what if we die? Nigga, you already dead, nigga. Fuck you got to live for, nigga. Your species, that's what you got to stand for, nigga. So that this shit ends with us. So that it don't keep going on, nigga. We the last generation, nigga. They took everything from us. You already dead, nigga. What you scared to go? You gonna die anyway. You ain't alive. You ain't living. How you living? You don't even know who you is. You pay for everything. You don't even know who you is. You been dead, nigga. You a fucking slave. You get the fuck up every day and you go work all fucking day for them. And then come home and get a few hours of rest and then go do it all over again, nigga. All for your whole fucking life until you fucking die, nigga. So you already fucking dead, nigga. You're gonna leave here one day anyway. Even though death isn't real, your soul is going to leave here anyway. Niggas acting like, hey, if we don't rebel, we gonna live on this bitch forever. Nigga, you're going to leave here one day anyway. You goofy ass, scary ass house Negroes. You acting like being a house Negro gonna stop them from trying to take your goofy ass out. You can be a house Negro all you want, and they still be going upside y'all shit.
And eventually, your thoughts will stop. They just stop running through. All right? And you left with nothingness and this emptiness and this supreme peace. You know what I'm saying? It's just supreme peace. And from that point, you can set your intent or you could just flow. And if you just flow with the astral realms, you can see wherever it leads you to, or you can set your intent to go to a specific place, location, all of it. You know what I'm saying? And it's in these states where you start to tap into the, seek out the plasma energy. You know, see it running through. You know that it's real first. And then you ask, you link it to it. You know, this is where people that practice voodoo and hoodoo, they get into these meditative states and they get to talking to certain ancestors and reaching out to certain ancestors to do certain things. This is why they was always able to do that in those magical genres, if you want to call them genres, all right? This is why, because they work and they dealing with certain principalities and energy fields that are all connected to you, the one that's in you. And you can't feel these energy fields if you don't connect with them, all right? And if you somebody that's still thinking like, oh, voodoo is bad, and voodoo this and that, and hoodoo is bad, then you will never tap into your abilities. Before you say it's bad, don't go off what they told you. Go read up on it yourself. See the origins of it, and you're going to see this is the build. This is what your ancestors, meaning your great-great-great-great-grandmama and your great-great-great-great-granddaddy was doing.
I don't know if it's just a me thing, but I really be this close to losing it, like, so much. I don't think people realize, like, how on the fucking brim I am of losing my goddamn mind.
So did y'all know Disney Channel made their stars in a lab? The more I talk about this, the more you're gonna think I'm a conspiracy theorist, but watch this.
So the stars that we see on TV are actually grown right here?
That's correct. They're grown and developed here. We engineer their brains for advanced singing and dancing capabilities, even posing for photos. By the time they grow to desired size, these child stars are fully ready for the camera or the concert tours or whatever Disney chooses to put them in.
Bruh, I'm not gonna lie. That just destroyed my Disney Channel childhood. Can't even look at Disney Channel the same no more. I know y'all just seen that. What do y'all think about that? But y'all probably like, no, that's not real, that's not real. It'd be like y'all quick to call something a conspiracy when it's right in front of your face. As much as y'all want to deny this, but then y'all already know they trying to replace everything with artificial intelligence and AI, which they've been doing it for years. They've been doing it to rappers and celebrities. If you don't believe me, Tom McDonald has came out with this song called Clone Rappers. If you go tune into that, he will basically tell you everything what they do to these rappers.
And y'all want to know what really made my stomach turn upside down is when they said Zac Efron was grown in a lab. This guy that played in my favorite movie, High School Musical. Take a look at this.
Yes, Zach was actually one of our earliest
models. My daughters love him. I mean, he looks so real.
Actually, I think we could have done a better job with...
Hold on, did I just hear that? Because I know I ain't the only one who just heard that. Go rewind that if y'all didn't catch what he said. Honestly, I ain't even gonna lie, that's just messed up. But look, bruh. Everybody that's watching Disney Channel, you don't even know if you're looking at the person that's real or not. We in the Matrix. Follow for more.
Shout out to the gods. Just checking in today because some of you are going through battles within your mind for the last few weeks. I have been under attack myself. I keep talking about this war that we in, the spiritual situation that we are navigating ourselves through. It's important, it's imperative to be very conscientious about how we deal with these spiritual attacks. You cannot deal with spiritual attacks through carnal thinking, with carnality, with a gun, beating somebody up. I mean, you can, but you're still gonna, you can win the fight and you still lose.
I wasn't rich since I was a kid. I was in the street selling crack.
All right, man. Hey.
Rich my whole life. I didn't grow up on TV. I went to...
Hey, man, calm down.
I went to public school.
Peace, peace, peace. Peace and love, family. I had to come ground myself, shining, it's a beautiful day. I advise y'all to go. Make you wanna some nature, man. Go get you some sun. You know, take your shoes and socks off. Ground yourself in Mother Nature, man.
Here I am.
I don't know about y'all, but I need some cleansing.
Can you understand?
And y'all, somebody leave me a comment. Let me know. I've had like a sinus headache for like the past 3 days, man. Like just right up here. You feel me? It's been hurting for like the past 3 days. This past weekend, like I don't know. Somebody tell me what that's about. Peace and love.
Daily affirmation.
I deserve a lifetime of happiness. I deserve a lifetime of happiness. I deserve a lifetime of happiness.
The Ankh is an electromagnetic device. You see it in the hands of the gods. You also see us carrying a scepter, which is a device we use to move stones for pyramids, which we use to harness electromagnetic energy. We
ain't no hell now, but y'all wanna fucking keep picking this weird ass nigga up.
Man, just leave him alone.
Man,
just
shut up. Man, I don't get no fuck. Oh, that nigga don't never try to sit by me. Lame ass nigga. Fuck night playing ass nigga. How the fuck, nigga? What the fuck you got going on? What the fuck, nigga ass trying to build? Okay. Fuck, I ran out of mat. Okay. I ran out of
weird ass.
Hey, which $1 nigga put y'all hands on my son at Buster? He finna get hit one.
Man, I can't wait to pay this ass.
Okay, beat him up.
Choose your fighter.
He's not ass, baby. You gotta beat him up.
I just cut his attack. He must can't see me no more.
You ain't tripping. Dumb ass nigga.
Fuck wrong. His power level way higher than usual. I gotta get ass back again, bro. How you wasn't prepared this time, was you? What y'all nigga gonna do, jump me? Both of us are Super Saiyan, so
man, what the fuck is you talking about, bro? I got this blood on me, straight gunplay. We not doing no fight, nigga.
Gunplay, you don't have to talk about. What the hell you got going? You need to go fight his ass, twin. Fight him? Did you not read his power level? It's incredible high right now.
Nigga, power level, this ain't no fucking game, it's real.
Just give me a couple years, I'm gonna go home and train.
You finna go home and pack your shit and go to your dad's house, cause I can't deal with your weird ass.
I hate you, bitch. I hate you too.
One of the things that we black people find ourselves faced with is a black body speaking English and thinking Greek. I no longer think the way my mama used to think. And why is that important? Because I want to heal myself. I'm sick now. I'm stressed. I'm very stressed. All of us are.
I'm just in Walmart, right? And I'm just looking at these candles, and then I come across this candle. It says Siete Potencia Africanas, right? So seven African powers, that's what that means, right? So it's got Oshun, a white woman. It got Yemela, which they mean Yemaya, which is not a white woman. And Obatala, which is a black man. And then it says Shango, and it's a woman. Shango is a black man. Arula, it has Jesus. And then Ogun, which is Ogun, is a white man. And Ilegua. Everybody know that these, and it says African, y'all. It says Siente Proticias Africanas, seven African powers, child. I can't, I cannot. Walmart, get y'all shit together.
Okay, so if this video finds you, then this message is for you. Honey, you know it had to be some serious if I'm on here in my bunnies, okay? Yes, honey, it's serious. Stop the video right now. Get you a pen and paper. You're going to need it. Okay, I'm coming with instructions. In this next space for the next few days, you have to come with aggression. What is yours, but you got to know that it's yours. So I'm going to give you a few words to be saying in your reality to help you understand and receive that it's yours. Okay, you ready? I declare and I decree that everything that I have sent up must come down. It is so and it is sealed, Ararita. I want you to say that for the next few days and watch what God do. Watch what Mother Father do on your behalf. Because what's yours is yours and nobody can take that. Now Jules has spoken.
Bro, watch who y'all meet on TikTok, bro. No lie, bro. This on everything, bro. I drove from...
Go watch that video. I've been saying this for the longest on this app. So, I'm going to tell you what happened to my friend. So, my buddy goes to meet this young lady on this app. And 2 weeks went by. She said, oh my gosh, I can't wait to see you. I want to see you. And I said, hey man, take a couple of months. Maybe see her in the fall or the winter. Sometime like that. After you put some time in on the phone with her. FaceTime her. Do more. Don't be so quick to go down there. So, he ain't listen to me. He was like, oh, Joe, you don't know what you're talking about. You're a dinosaur, right? Stop being so paranoid. So I said, yo, this doesn't sound right. So she said, oh, when you come down here, I'll cook for you and I'll do this. I said, wait a minute. You gonna stay at her house? And he said, yeah. I said, she got kids, right? He said, yeah, bro, don't do that. She's not nothing. That doesn't sound right, bro. And I told him, I said, dude, no woman is gonna let you stay with her kids or even know where she live at and she got kids. Nah, man, this doesn't sound right. He's like, oh, man, you don't know what you're talking about. I said, yo, get a hotel or even I'll pay for it. Get a hotel and a rental car. He said, no, she'll pick me up from the airport. Okay, cool. I said, dude, this doesn't sound right. So when the day come, she said, oh, my car's messed up. I can't pick you up from the airport. Can you catch an Uber? I said, bro, at this point, you need to abort mission. This doesn't sound right, man. She trying to set you up. Man, you don't know what you're talking about. You always accusing people. You always was, no. So long story short, I said, okay, he gets a rental car. I told him to do this, and men, do this. I said, tell her you're going to stop off at the hotel, you're going to put your stuff there, and then you're going to come on your way. What you're going to do is you're going to go, you're going to sit invisible to her. She can't see you. Just sit out there and see who comes in and out of the house, right? Then send her a text and say, hey, I'm on my way. He did it. He was a couple of blocks up the street. He sent a text, said, hey, I'm on my way. He could see the house. Coming around the corner was three dudes. You could tell that they had something on them, right? And they went in the house with masks on. And I told him, I said, see, this is why you have to practice safety wherever you go. Now, his life could have been taken because he was chasing some tail. And when I tell you men this, and when I tell y'all women this, y'all laugh and joke at me. But this video right here can show you and tell you why you need to be safety. Stop playing with your daggone life. Or it may be the last time you play with it.
to all so-called black people, especially ones of the spiritual community. The elites and the people high up do not care if we wake up. They don't care if we get to a higher level of consciousness. They don't care if you stop calling yourself black and start calling yourself African or Anunnaki or even Aboriginal. They don't care if we protest and continue to make posts. They don't care if you learn the truth about your reparations, your property, and your goods. It's only one thing that can really make them worry. Do you want to know what that is? The day that black men stop killing other black men and stop disrespecting and hurting black women. The day that black women stop disrespecting and hurting other black women and black men. The day that you can no longer make jokes that black children don't know their fathers because they're all in the homes. The day that we no longer destroy our own communities with drugs given to us by the elites. And then finally, the day that we disassemble from all of their religions, sports, and anything else we were taught not originally known.
You are about to experience real love, divine counterpart, divine love. You are finna be valued. You're finna be respected. You understand? You're finna find that person who's gonna fight for you, but it ain't no chaos. It ain't no reason for you to fight for you, but they'll go for war for you if it was the cause. You understand, though? You finna meet that person who love you, who gonna stand for you. When you're not around, they gonna let nobody slander your name or talk about you. You understand? That's the type of person you finna meet. You understand? Peace to the guys and goddess, divine message.
Peace to all the gods and goddesses of Planet Kai. Peace to the high vibrational beings. Netflix. This movie. Fast Color. I need every god and goddess to go watch it if you haven't seen it already. Some gems in it. Damn sure some gems at the end if you listening. And you know, you know what I'm saying? You got that first eye open, third eye open, facts. Wait, which one is it again? First Eye? Yeah, that. Anyway, whatever. Look, go watch the movie. Go Fast Color. All goddess role, by the way. All the main role. Spots. Goddesses. All of them. You know what I'm saying? That's what I like, too. I'm like, I fucks with this movie. But this is basically about our fucking DEA on a sneak tip. Like, they ain't show too much, but they showed enough. Especially at the end, if you listen...
What's wrong with black people to this day? We hate each other for no reason, for no cause. Everything we done been through and still go through to this day, but we still look at each other. Instead of pointing the finger somewhere, we still have so much aggressive upon each other. Nowadays, we pass each other, we can't even say hello, how are you? Have a good day. Yet we mean more, we look them up and down, we stare in their face. If we say anything to a person, they ready to fight. Wherever it came to, when we're some of the strongest peoples in the world.
He need to leave that dope alone. Need to leave that dope alone.
We gotta heal, man. You know what I'm saying? We have to heal so that we can be, you have to heal so that you can be at your strongest. A lot of shadow work, a lot of sitting with self, a lot of no regret. Let all the regrets go. We moving into new energy. Let all the regrets go, y'all. Let leave that's negative energy. Fuck what didn't go right in the past. Fuck what went wrong. Fuck enough. Don't worry about that. You worry about the wrong shit. Just focus on what you want to do now moving forward. Don't even remember nothing else. But anything bad in your life that you regret, you can erase that shit. Like your brain and computer, you can just erase that shit out your shit. Just take it out. Like, dude, it never happened. Literally, like, it's out. It's gone. It's only going to stay.
Rashad Jamal Free.
Hey.
Rashad Jamal free.
Stop saying free, Rashad Jamal.
Rashad Jamal free.
They say we Rashad Jamal free.
Y'all niggas fucked up.
He helped y'all. The way y'all can't help
Rashad
him.
Rashad Jamal free.
Rashad Jamal. He freed up.
You got a lot of narcissists in your family, man. I'm feeling that, yo. You got a lot, you, whoever I'm talking to, you. You got a lot of narcissists in your family. Thank you so much for the King Crown. Thank you. Like, they just evil as fuck. I don't like this energy. Ugh, get this away from me. I don't like this. These people are demonic, man. And it's like, you're the only one that's a light worker. Like, everybody else, they got gifts, but they dark, though. Like, you a light worker. That's why they want to go against you. Whoever these people are, man, please keep them out your energy, man. Please. Keep these people out your energy, family. They've been going against you your whole life. And been smiling in your face, family. For real. I'm telling you what I know, man. I don't like this energy I'm feeling, man, because a lot of them, they talk bad about you. You ain't never done nothing to these people but show love to these family members. Like, they actually speaking about you right now. About what you looking like, about what you're eating, about what you're posting, about what you're doing, how you living your life. A lot of people gang stalking your page to see that them not being in your life is actually affecting you, but it's not. That's why they despise you. They hate your strength. They hate the fact that you can do this shit alone, man. They actually are codependent on each other, and they wanted you to be codependent on them. But you're not like that. You're a different breed. You cut from a different cloth. That's not you. That's not you, family. Damn, these people wicked, man. I don't know who I'm talking to, but yo, hey, listen. Some of these people that dabbling in some dark ass energy, man. I'm telling you what I know. Some of these people dabble in some dark ass energy that they gotta pay back. They try to use you as a scapegoat. Whoever I'm talking to, they try to use you as an scapegoat because you live in love and light. I don't like this energy, man. These people are wicked, man. These people are evil, man. They tried to sacrifice you. Whoever you are, they tried to sacrifice you. I don't like that shit. I don't know whoever I'm talking to. Remember, take what resonates and leave the rest. If it don't fit you, it ain't you. But I'm telling you, I feel like who I'm talking to, your family members evil as fuck. They might smile and act like, you know, they cool. You know what I'm saying? They might got a little following. See, somebody in your family might can own a church. Somebody can be a pastor. Somebody can actually be like some type of religious figure or maybe a public figure. And they trying to act like that there's somebody that they're not, man. That shit about to be exposed, man. All that shit about to be exposed. For whoever I'm talking to, that shit about to be exposed. Because they shape-shifting. And people starting to see these people for who they truly are, man. That's on everything. These people been dabbling in dark magic. And they try to make it seem like you was crazy, but you're not, though. You're actually the light worker. You are the light worker. They try to make it seem like that you was evil because you spiritual. I don't know who I'm talking to, man. I don't like this energy. I don't like this energy, man. So I'm telling you, please, you got to do some type of spiritual bath. Do a spiritual bath, family. It's time to cut these cords. You got to get out in nature. You got to burn your Palo Santo and your sage, man. Make sure you do that. Also, make sure you get a black tourmaline crystal. A black tourmaline or a black obsidian. You need some type of protection over your energy. Please get that.
One of the biggest scams that the government does is they put us into fear about a lot of these storms. Understand that we have a direct relationship with the earth. So anything wanting the earth to end and to ruin is the fucking Antichrist.
When the smoke and cameras disappear again, the real world is bigger than all these fake ass records. Wait, poor folks got the millions and my woman's disrespected. If you check 1-2, my word of advice to you is just relax. Just do what you got to do. If that don't work, then kick the facts. If you were fired.
So that's why it's important for you to take care of you, man, because y'all, this world is cruel. So if you are one of these lucky ones who got a support system or you got a good friend or or two, or a good family member or two, man, you need to cherish those people. You need to cherish that energy. And y'all need to come together and start manifesting happiness, prosperity, abundance, and things of that nature, man. But at the end of the day, all you have is you. It's a lot of people still waiting for somebody to pop out them clouds and save them from all this madness, y'all. And I'm telling you, I'm not saying this to discourage or to completely strip anybody from their faith, y'all. That's not what I'm about. But I have to be real. There's no white man coming to save nobody. And as far as our ancestors coming back and fighting this spiritual force, I mean, fighting this spiritual fight that's going on, this spiritual warfare that's going on, our people are coming back along with other spiritual forces that are on our team and also a part of us and also our gods and goddesses and things of that nature. Y'all, we coming back. Our people coming back. People with locks, carbon in their skin. You feel me? We coming back. Ain't no white man coming back. Ain't no Jesus coming back. I mean, you can call them whatever you want to call them, but yeah, that whole idea, you have to lose that. I'm sorry. Because you're going to be looking up in those clouds waiting forever while oppressors are doing whatever they doing. You feel me? And you so looking up, yo ass not paying attention to the true facts that us gods and goddesses are presenting, because you scared, you looking for a cop out, you looking for this false entity to come save you, man, and it's not gonna happen. I'm sorry, it's not gonna happen. We have to save us. But if you're not paying attention to the true esoterical facts that's being presented, these true cosmic facts that's being presented, man, you ain't gonna know what to do. But I love y'all, man, and I love myself.